Hi everyone, welcome to the Department of Value Education. I am Sir Gregory Karumnoit. Today also I am very happy to be with you to share and reflect together with you on an important topic or theme, that is the social responsibility. I am sure all of you are familiar with the term corporate social responsibility, or CSR. I believe you have heard, you are familiar with this term, isn't it? CSR is something which every company or corporation is mandated to adopt or to practice. CSR is a company's way of giving back to the society something good, something valuable, something that would help mitigate the pains and suffering of others. No, of course, out of the profit from their business or from their undertakings. Not only corporations or companies do this. We also have examples of so many individuals in their own capacity who have taken social responsibility to heart. They follow the maxim of, life has given me so much. Now it is my turn, my sacred duty to contribute something for the betterment of others. In this context, I am reminded of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam's definition of education. I am sure you still remember Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, isn't it? He said, for me to be educated means the transformation of myself from what I can get to what I can give. It's wonderful. Indeed, he was a person who lived by this maxim. And he collapsed and died while giving. He was sharing his knowledge and wisdom with the students of IIM Shillong when he collapsed and eventually passed away at the hospital just moments later. During the course of our discussion or reflection today, I'll be sharing with you stories of people who have gone out of their way doing something good for others and the society in spite of the odds that they have encountered or the bad experiences, the loss in their own personal life. Let's try and learn and emulate their example. And there is a saying which says, it is better to light a candle than curse the darkness. Fine. So let us begin today's session by listening, and I would invite those of you who know, who are familiar with this song, to even sing together also. It's a wonderful song, that is the Carry Your Candle, so that we can set the tone for our reflection today.
There is a candle in every soul, some brightly burning, some dark and cold. There is a spirit who brings a fire, ignites a candle, and makes his home. So carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the hopeless, confused and see to raise our candles and light up the sky, praying to our Father in the name of Jesus. Make us a beacon in darkest times. So carry your candle, run to the darkness, seek out the helpless,
yes, go light your candle, because the world will become a better place. It's a wonderful song. Okay, you know, for doing something good, very often we wait for others to start. But there are also people who take initiatives, who take the first step for good things to happen. And let's watch this old video. Actually, it was an advertisement that was aired many years ago, and it had won a lot of appreciation and accolades. Let's see if we can learn something from this.
सर आपके लिए उस पार कार का इंतजाम किया है सर आइए सर ये ये चल चल
और चलो पकड़ के चलो फलक पकड़ के उठो और हवा पकड़ के चलो फलक पकड़ के उठो और हवा पकड़ के चलो
तुम चलो तो हिंदुस्तान चले तुम चलो तो हिंदुस्तान चले
As we go ahead, we will be watching a few videos, as I have mentioned at the beginning, of ordinary people, but with extraordinary courage, or with that spirit of giving to others out of the blessings that they have received. And they are ordinary people with extraordinary service. So let us begin and let's watch these clips with an open mind and open heart, with a desire to learn something so that we can also do something good in turn.
Nearly 200 children, some of them from poorest families in Meghalaya, some of them blind, are getting a shot at free school. This thanks to Bartha Dhakar, who despite being blind, has a vision for these children.
Just another busy day in Shillong. The city barely has the time to notice Pin Shim Lang or the sound of her walking stick. But she doesn't mind.
We don't care whoever take care of us. Our headmistress, Miss Bartha Dhakar, is there to look after us.
Bartha G. Dhakar is more than a teacher for these children. 52-year-old Bartha has dedicated her life to educating disabled children in Meghalaya. Bartha was born with a failing eyesight, which she lost completely while pursuing her master's in Bangalore.
I was denied even to apply a job in a mainstream school because then people thought that, it's not possible for an almost blind person to work as a teacher.
The big change came in 1998 when, with the help of Bethany Society, an NGO, she started the Jyoti Srot School for the visually impaired. But there was a bigger problem. The absence of a braille script in Khasi language.
Without having a script for blind children to read and write in Khasi, is as if they have no access to learning the Khasi paper by itself.
So Bartha took on the arduous task of learning English braille herself, and after 2 long years, she was able to invent the braille code for Khasi language.
So it was a time of a challenge and also of an opportunity of learning and seeing new things myself.
Today, the braille script in Khasi has given students like Pin Shim Lang the confidence of becoming a lawyer and help others like her. There are about 100 blind and 50 sighted children of poor families in this school. This free school runs primarily on donations and is battling shortage of funds and losing good teachers. But undeterred, Bertha and her students move on, relishing every moment of life.
Miss Bertha Dhakar, she could have just given up and said, "Poor me, what else can I do? I have lost my eyesight." She would have been at the mercy of her loved ones or others, and I believe they wouldn't mind because she needed their help. But instead, she chose to be a blessing for others. Her disability did not prevent her from doing good to others because she felt that she could still contribute to the society out of the blessings that she had received. Let's go to the next.
Well, the thing I remember most going to a circus was a clown, a dwarf who entertained us. None of us saw the human side of him. But Pavitra Rava from Assam did, and he's changing their lives through drama and theater.
Behind this painted smile, there are many tales of joy and sorrow. But all we see is a joker. Nobody knows it better than James Daimari, who was a circus clown for 18 long years.
हम लोग तो जानवर का जीव है बाबा तो मानता है यार तो आदमी लोग हंसता है हम लोग को इज्जत नहीं है क्या आज
About 2 years ago, James's prayer for a life of dignity was answered. It all started when he embarked on a new journey of hope with Povitro Radha. An NSD graduate, Povitro has assembled some 30 dwarves from across Assam for a unique experiment in theatre.
जो काम आप और मैं कर सकता हूँ जो हम लोग कर सकते हैं वो कहीं ना कहीं ये लोग भी कर सकते हैं ये लोग जैसे फिजिकल हैंडीकैप्स जो कानों से ठीक से सुनता नहीं है जो बोल नहीं सकते हैं जो दिखता नहीं है तो उनके लिए सरकार के पास है कुछ ना कुछ स्कीम्स लेकिन इनके लिए कुछ भी नहीं है
These dwarves live together in Povitro's ancestral home and all expenses are borne by him. The money comes from the theatre workshops that Povitro conducts. All these little actors need to do is rehearse every day under Povitro's watchful eyes. Mastering each move, perfecting each look. It may look fun, but it's serious business for Povitro and his theatre group of dwarves called Dapon.
Good, okay, stop.
Dapon means darpan, mirror. That means the reflection of our life, society.
So far, Dapon has done about 15 shows in Assam and Delhi. Each artist in the group earns about 2,000 rupees a month. There's a constant shortage of funds. Life is tough, but Povitro knows a bigger change is around the corner.
जो कॉन्फिडेंस सबसे बड़ी बात है उसमें काफी बदलाव है वो घर से बाहर नहीं निकलना चाहते थे अब वो आपके साथ भी जैसे बातचीत करते हैं दूसरे लोगों के साथ भी जो बातचीत करते हैं वो बहुत नॉर्मल है दैट मीन्स वो एक इंसान होने के नाते जो आदमियों से मिलना जो एक कॉन्फिडेंट होता है सो वो चेंज सबसे बड़ी है
Dapon is also joining hearts. Tora and Nayan met here during rehearsals, and in each other, they have found what they could never have dreamt of: love.
I never thought that someone like me can get married. It's like a dream come true for me.
These stories are Povitro's biggest achievements. He has no regrets of giving up a lucrative stint in theatre and films in Mumbai to come back to his home in Tongla. Povitro dreams of a village called Amar Gaon for his little actors, a place where their physical appearance doesn't matter.
Amar Gaon ka concept hai aage ka zindagi jo hai usko safal banane ke liye unko vocational training diya jaye. Zameen hamare paas hai lekin usme infrastructure khada karne ke liye hamare paas abhi financial madad कहीं से भी डायरेक्टली नहीं मिल रहा है हमें अपने बलबूते पे करना पड़ रहा है
बट फॉर नाउ Dapon इज ऑल अबाउट द स्मॉल जॉयज Akshay Da is happy just to see that his children are not dwarves. James is glad that finally he's living a life of dignity. And Povitro is happy just to have his little actors around him.
This gentleman had the opportunity of making it big in Bollywood even. He would have earned tons of money, but no. He chose instead to lift up the downtrodden and the marginalized. He too had a sense of responsibility to do something good for others.
Parmeshwaran and Chudamani lost their three children in the 2004 tsunami. But in their sorrow, they found a new reason to live. They reached out to the many children who were orphaned by the same tsunami in Nagapattinam.
There was 25 boys playing a volleyball. The fishermen village people are fishing and buying. And then my two daughters, they were writing something on the sand. I was playing with the frisbee with my son. For 10 minutes we played. When I threw on the frisbee, my son was just he took about throw. Before throwing, daddy, daddy, look at the ocean. When I'm turning back, there was about 20 feet height of the whale standing behind us. I told my son, Kirbasan, run, run fast. He was running. Till today, I can make it, his legs are running in my mind. By the time other waves lifting up so high and hitting the ground, till today, I can't remember how I lost my son from my hand.
As the tsunami swept through the coast of Nagapattinam, Parmeshwaran lost his three children to the ocean. Hours later, shattered and all alone, he returned home to his wife.
As a mother, it is a very difficult one, because not even one is left over, you know. That particular day, because I could see both my husband and myself standing as a zero, as we were in 91.
Over the next 3 days, as the ocean calmed down, the storm inside Chudamani raged on. Traumatized and shocked, she didn't speak a word. Finally, on the fourth day, Chudamani spoke to her husband.
Fourth day, I just wanted to go and see around what's happening. If at all we can do some help, we can.
There was 60 children, they lost their parents.
I see my children in this group. If they come with us, that place, you know, where we are missing our children, that place will be filled with these children.
With four children, Chudamani and Parmeshwaran started their new home. Soon as the years passed, more and more children joined their home Nambikai, meaning the helping hand. Today the couple has 26 children to care for, all with a tragic past. Not every child in is a tsunami orphan.
They used to cry themselves alone. When we found, immediately they'll wipe their tears and they'll say no, no, nothing.
Satyavan lost his mother in the tsunami and was amongst the first four kids to come to Nambikai. Today he's studying marine engineering and is an inspiration for younger kids like Rajkumar at Nambikai. Rajkumar is in the 6th standard and is trying very hard to erase his past.
My father was a drunkard. One night he came home and in front of our eyes, he burned my mother. She died.
Helping these children dream again is a mission for Chudamani and Parmeshwaran. Nambikai is a happy household. On a holiday, you'll find Chudamani cooking for her kids, the tiny ones peacefully napping near their mom, and Parmeshwaran teaching the older ones the important lessons of life. But does it get difficult for this couple, who are in regular government jobs, to provide for 26 children?
Money is not an issue. It is not at all an issue.
We both are working and supporting. Apart from that, some of the friends are helping. We don't have any so far. We never face any problem for this.
Still living by the ocean, Chudamani and Parmeshwaran feel a strange connection with it. It's the ocean that once washed away their hopes and dreams.
And really we miss them. It's not so easy to forget them, no?
But it's also the same ocean that got them close to their 26 children.
I cried, you know. Somebody is there to call me Amma.
We are not helping the kids. The children came here and living with us, they are helping us to survive.
You know, in spite of the terrible personal tragedy and loss, this couple still had the heart to reach out to others. They found meaning in doing good. Sometimes we tend to be generous to others out of the abundance of what we have or the extra. However, from this video, we can learn that despite our own loss or misfortune, we can still do good deeds. We can still be a blessing for others.
Dr. is changing the landscape of Madhya Pradesh with pure ingenuity. Anil Joshi collects 1 rupee from each villager and with the money pooled, he builds check dams. In a region parched by drought, Dr. Joshi's intervention is bringing about a green revolution.
Year 2008. Mandsaur, a small district in Madhya Pradesh, was battling the worst drought with almost no rain for 8 years. Farmers lost their livelihood and women walked miles to fetch water. A doctor, Anil Joshi, realized how scarcity of water was making life impossible for the villagers. Anil knew that the only way he could help the farmers was by preserving the precious little rain that they received, and for that they needed to build dams, which needed a capital of at least 1 lakh rupees.
मेरे दिमाग में विचार आया कि प्रति व्यक्ति से 1 रुपया ले लिया जाए, जो उसके लिए कोई विशेष मायने नहीं रखता, और हमारे आसपास के क्षेत्र से 1 लाख लोग हो भी जाएंगे.
With his 1 rupee idea, Anil went door to door collecting money.
प्रति व्यक्ति घर से जन सहयोग 1 रुपया मांग रहे, 1 रुपया तो दे दो कम से कम पानी के नाम.
Some joined his cause, some ridiculed him, and others mistrusted him. But in 3 months he collected the money, and soon Anil Joshi had his own team. And in 10 days the dam was ready. And the rewards came with the very next rainfall.
बांध बनाने के तुरंत 8 दिन बाद ही आसपास के क्षेत्र के हैंडपंप और कुओं में पानी बढ़ गया और लोग खुशी हो गए, ताली से झूम उठे. आज 11 डैम बन के कम्प्लीट हुए, इससे कम से कम 20-25 गांव के लोगों को लाभ हुआ. मेरा तो ये उद्देश्य है कि लोग मुझे पानी वाले बाबा कहे, अनिल जोशी कहे, डॉक्टर साहब कहे या गाली दे, मेरे साथ धन से नहीं तो कम से कम तन से और मन से साथ हो जाए.
Wonderful story, isn't it? You know, this to solve any problem or to extend a helping hand to others, we need to take the initiative, however small such initiative may be. You know, this doctor had a desire to mitigate the pains and sufferings of others. He did not seek wealth or fame. He has just used his talent and gift to give back to the society. I invite all of us, if we can, we can contribute something to those in need. You know, the as there is a saying that the good deed that you do to others today, that person might have been praying for it yesterday. So life has given us so much. Why not give back something to those who are in need, something to the society? And I think that will make our society and the world at large a better place. Thank you. Nice to have been with you, and may God bless you. Bye till we meet again next time. Thank you very much.